Election Day is wrapping up and residents have made their way to the polls. Hi, I'm Roxanne Hill.
And I'm Will Wadsworth. Thank you for joining us for today's newscast. This is Bobcat Update. The polls are closed, and later this evening, we'll know who San Marcos residents have selected to serve on the City Council. Two positions are up for grabs. Places 1 and 2 were contested. City employees Maxfield Baker and Mark Gleason each campaigned for Place 1, while Place 2 incumbent Saul Gonzalez fought Texas State student Devin Barrett and self-described city watchdog Lisa Marie Coppoletta. Hays County voters had several choices to make on issues affecting local communities. Bobcat Update's Haley Ray has the story.
The city of San Marcos had early voting through last week, and one of the polling locations is at Texas State. Many students saw it as an opportunity to participate in local issues and vote on possible solutions.
Students oftentimes kind of check out on these, especially odd year elections, but these issues are going to continue to impact them the entire time they live here. And especially this year, we have a lot of propositions on the ballot as well, kind of coming from the state level. So propositions last longer than politicians.
It's important that everybody realize that there are some amendments being proposed this time, even though it's not a presidential election, that it's still an important election to look at.
Hays County Election Administrator Jennifer Anderson says voting in local elections is just as important as voting on statewide and national tickets. Anderson says that's because local elections have been the biggest impact on the community.
If they align themselves with what your values are, to actually make sure you put those people in place, because it can really shape what San Marcos is, not just now, but it'll affect us in 5 or 10 years.
We'll have the results of the election on tomorrow's Bobcat Update.
The 11th Annual International Research Conference for graduate students is being observed this week at Texas State. The opening panel will highlight the common experience theme, truth. Speakers will be discussing the importance of finding truth through research. They'll be talking about their professional experiences. There will be a poster session this Thursday at the Round Rock campus. San Marcos has millions of dollars to spend as a result of two historic floods 4 years ago. Bobcat Update's Daisy Cologne reports on the city's efforts aimed at getting local feedback on how the money should be spent.
The city has until March of next year to submit a mitigation action plan, which will outline how $24 million will be spent to help prevent or reduce damages resulting from disasters. One city official said the community's input is vital in taking the next step forward in the decision-making process.
What we're looking for is public feedback and comments on what is most important to them and how to best spend this money to prevent future disasters.
Residents are being asked to take the survey to rank the most critical needs of the community. The results of the survey will help determine which concerns will be given priority and how funding will be divided. One resident questions if the grant will be enough.
I think it's useful. I don't know if it's going to be enough. If it's actually used for projects and not paid to a bunch of consultants and committees and stuff like that, then I think it'll be useful.
The needs of the community are important factors to take into consideration when deciding which projects get looked at first. San Marcos officials say they hope to prevent disasters from happening again.
We'll have a draft plan presented to council in December, and then ultimately it'll be submitted to HUD in March of 2020.
The $24 million that was awarded to the city in wake of the two historic floods back in 2015 must be entirely spent by 2022. For Bobcat Update, I'm Daisy Cologne.
A lawsuit has been filed against the Trump administration to try to stop efforts to roll back regulations on light bulb efficiency. The administration wants to overturn Obama-era requirements that it claims will increase bulb prices by almost 300%. However, environmental groups say that claim is not true. More than a dozen attorneys general have filed suit in conjunction with the environmentalists who want the rules to go into effect.
The fall season means homeowners will have more leaves to rake and dispose of. Bobcat Update's O'Brien Morales tells us about a beneficial way to get rid of those leaves.
Trees are adjusting to the temperatures dropping and the sun setting sooner. Leaves are falling in the greater numbers this time of year. The City of San Marcos and a student group called Bobcat Blend have teamed up to provide a composting program for the accumulated leaves.
I talked with Dr. Kate about partnering with their program, Bobcat Blend, and how we could help them. And one of the things that they get a lot of is the green material for composting, which is all the food waste from the cafeterias, and they needed more brown, which would be leaves. And we always have bags of people calling in a bulk pickup for bags of leaves, and I thought it would be best if we didn't put that in the landfill, but we provided that for Bobcat Blend. They can bring their bags to 401 East Hopkins, which is the Grant Harris Building.
After the leaves have been collected, the Bobcat Blend composting program will turn its attention to Christmas trees that are discarded after the holidays.
So starting December 26th, they will put a cage out here, and any live Christmas trees without tinsel or lights or ornaments can be brought here. It'll be here until the Friday before the second Saturday in January.
The composting collection program will continue until November 15th. For Bobcat Update, I'm Brian Marias.
Coming up, we'll hear more about the Hays County Food Bank and their annual Turkeys Tackling Hunger food drive.
And we have a story on how early darkness is having an impact on Texas State students. We'll be right back.
To some, it may simply mean food in a plastic tin, but to others, it could mean a blessing. This is Meals on Wheels.
Oh, well, it is a blessing, first of all, and I do appreciate all the that they've done, you know, the ones that prepare the meals, and my mobility is very difficult. So there's times that really just like not even safe for me to be at the stove.
Meals on Wheels strives to provide any person over the age of 60 who is on Medicaid a daily hot meal right to their doorstep. Volunteers make up most of the organization and help the idea of providing daily meals for the community a reality.
Well, I'm the site manager for, this is our Allenwood site. We gather meals and put together meals for our homebound clients. We put out about 80 meals a day, and we have somewhere between 60 to 75 hot meals that we send out to our homebound clients. And we have somewhere around 15 clients that come in and eat lunch with us, and we serve them a hot lunch here.
If you want to be able to provide an incredible service and be the helping hand for those who need it most, call 800-333-6325 or visit MealsOnWheelsCentralTexas.org.
Jury selection in the trial of Roger Stone started today, but the defendant was forced to leave early in the proceedings. Stone told the judge he was not feeling well due to food poisoning. He faces charges of lying to Congress while being investigated by former special counsel Robert Mueller, who was looking into Russian interference in the 2016 election. Stone is a longtime friend of President Trump.
Clocks have been returned to Central Standard Time, which means Texas State students are adjusting to new patterns of light and darkness. With nights seeming to creep up faster this time of year, the change can affect how people feel. Bobcat Update's Bryn McCurley has the story.
For some students, the changing seasons and clock adjustments contribute to seasonal affective disorder.
Seasonal depression or seasonal affective disorder is really a subtype of depression, which you might see in major depressive disorder, or you might even see it in bipolar disorder. It occurs in a very cyclic way, so it seems to occur at the same time of the year every year.
Even if you're not among those who battle depression, the seasonal changes can affect you.
There's something about having the shorter days and the loss of sunlight that affects the neurochemicals in the brain and leads to some of the symptoms of depression that we see with that particular type of disorder.
There are different forms of treatments for those who feel they could be dealing with seasonal affective disorder.
In cases where you have very mild seasonal affective disorder, light therapy by itself can work. And the way light therapy works is you use a special kind of white light every morning when you first wake up, that you will spend about 30 minutes in front of that special light. If a student believes that they're suffering from depression of any type, then my recommendation is they come to the Student Health Center and see one of our medical providers.
For more information on mental health, you can visit the Student Health Center's website. This has been Bryn McCurley reporting for Bobcat Update. The Hays County Food Bank is entering the final months of its annual Turkeys Tackling Hunger Food Drive. Every fall, the food bank collects food and money donations across the county to make boxed meals for hungry families. The Turkeys Tackling Hunger event will continue through the Wednesday before Thanksgiving. For more information, you can visit their office in San Marcos or go to haysfoodbank.org.
Whether they're staying at home or on the go, many San Marcos residents start their day with a cup of joe. One coffee shop has been serving coffee for over a decade. Bobcat Update's Ernesto Santos has more.
Students have a variety of places to get their coffee. Tantra's, Wake the Dead, and Starbucks, to name just a few. One of the coffee houses has been serving brew in San Marcos for 16 years. Mocha's and Java's opened its doors in 2003. Owner Kevin Carswell says a lot of thought goes into every cup.
I think that quality is one reason people come back every day, is because we strive for that perfection and that quality customer service each day.
Carswell hires friendly people who are passionate about serving their customers. General Manager Jordan Gray has been working at Mocha's and Java's for over a year.
It's a fast, quick-paced environment, which I really like. I like working on my feet and working with my hands. I love working with customers as well.
Customers say they enjoy the laid-back atmosphere at Mocha's and Java's.
Starbucks is all right, but they're super friendly here. And they always have good music playing, plenty of space to study, and I've yet to have a bad experience here.
Mocha's and Java's has several locations in San Marcos, including shops at Wonder World Drive at Hunter Road, on North OBJ at Sesame, at the Central Texas Medical Center, and the Big HEB grocery store. For Bobcat Update, I'm Ernesto Santos.
Roxanne, how do you take your coffee?
Oh, Will, I just put a little bit of creamer, some sugar. How about you?
I take it black. First thing in the mornings, I need that pick-me-up to get the day started.
Ooh!
Just right.
Ooh-hoo-hoo. Thanks for joining us on Bobcat Update.
For more of our reports, you can visit the Bobcat Update YouTube page. Have a great rest of your night.